Yeah, Chicago.
What's that dance called again?
The Schmeider dance.
Yeah. The Schmeider dance?
Yeah.
Show me Bobby Schmeider. Mama send no pussy cats
inside my doghouse. What's your plan today then?
I have a blast out session here where I just fucking go for broke.
How you doing, man?
All right, lads.
Hey, gang.
Hi, buddy. Okay.
This gym's got so much history to it. You've only got to look around. Natasha Jonas, Tony Bellew, the Four Smith Brothers, little Frankie Stringer. Jeez, look at him, fucking Uncle Late, Uncle Festus, are you? He's been since he was like this big, to me. His daughter is Missy Bo Cairns, the Scouse captain for Liverpool women.
I drove past Everton, actually. It's first time I drove past the ground. Look yeah, quite nice. Nice. Do you go a lot? Season ticket holder.
If they give me just a ticket every game. Home and away, though. How funny is that, by the way? I always put pictures on, like, of me training. Because I've got my teeth, it tends to be my teeth all the time at the minute. Where's my zone? Right, we're going, lads. See, over the past few years, my striking's got better because he's my coach. And there was such a long time where he was like, I won't be in your corner because I don't know the MMA. And then after that fight in Vegas, he went, if I was there, you would have finished there. He said, I can't let you do that again. And then I promised him on the last 100, I went, I promise you I'll knock your old coach, I promise you. And then I did, so... I think you'll be able to see, like, when Ella speaks to me or when Paul speaks to me, there's a different level of, like, connection we have. But with me and him, we're boxing's me. I have it with Ellis as well in the MMA striking. But, like, I just feel like this is where I'm safe. With these four ropes and on this canvas, I'm home.
Yeah.
And he fills me up with such a confidence where I just feel like I'll fuck anyone. Yeah. My problem would be self-belief, I reckon. And you would have seen that, not last time, the time before you came, when we was doing that bit with Paddy, you could see the... I don't know, sometimes I'm too much in here, but then I believe that's why I'm as successful as what I am.
Yeah, definitely.
Do you know what I mean? So there's no kind of healthy balance with it. There's no happy meeting when I've been too relaxed and thought, this is how it should go, and I got beat. Mm. Do you know what I mean?
You suffered from imposter syndrome, right, for the first few fights?
Listen, a very long time. And then when I got beat by Santos, it was just like... But then my last two fights, that against that Kim, come on, she was supposed to beat me. Like, she was ranked 14 in the world at once. She had 10 inches on me. It was in fucking Vegas with the whole syndicate MMA there. That was built for her. And I didn't let it happen.
How did you feel when you saw Santos arguably beat Shevchenko?
Arguably... I said it online, respectfully, Santos. If the headbutt didn't happen, I think she would have clinched it. Without a question. It made me feel like I am elite level. And to the trolls and to everyone who want to just say, well, you fucking not, I am. I've took a round off it. I've took a round off Santos. And I don't think anyone else has.
You went the full three rounds or what?
29, 28.
All hard.
Could have got finished, could have got subbed, showed development in my game, and I came again, do you know what I mean? I lost actually after that and then came back again for two big wins, so this next fight is consistency. It's about being consistent, so I'm ready.
So Molly are fighting Hannah Goldie at UFC London, finally fighting somebody with a similar range. How is this going to fare for a different fight?
I think what we've noticed is, like, my fighting style has to be in the pocket or out of range, because mid-range and long-range, that's their golden ticket, but long-range fighters don't tend to fight inside very well. I mean, they can and they probably have some good shots, but not their forte, because they're used to keeping people off long. Where I come from amateur boxing, and we was taught everything comes off your jab. And if you watch me when I box and spar and box and still, I fight that way. It's just obviously when I'm in the cage, you can't do that. So to be able to just go back to everything that I grew up doing, it's a bit of a godsend. And you will have seen how the training's gone today in both aspects of punching and then MMA. It's just a lot more of a relaxed place to be, and when you don't have to expend that much energy thinking about the what ifs and just focusing on, well, I'm implementing this, you can go more like two red zone sessions there, and I'm good. Do you know what I mean? It's Friday. It's always scary going to a fight. Like, the whole process is fucking horrible, but I feel very content. I'm not in an overzealous way, I'm not in like a complacent way, just like my hard work is proper done. Like, Dustin Poirier, says it all the time, paid in full. I'm paying rent every day, so.
What did you think to Hannah before you'd had this fight lined up? Had you been following her career?
Seeing bits of it. I like everyone knows, I watch every single fight card, so she's got a dangerous counter left hook. Grappling's extremely strong. She looks like she's been on the gear her whole life, so if she hasn't, fucking fair play to you, love, because you're a mum as well. Do you know what I mean? So, like, fair play if you are just a natural athlete. Then I really applaud you, but if not, you're a little rat. I know she's got she's smart. She was on contender series. She wasn't ready, so she asked Dana for a bit of time off and then came back when she was. So she was smarter than me in that aspect, because when I got the call, I just fucking learned my biggest lesson in my debut, didn't I? So she's got a son. I'm taking the food out of her kid's mouth, essentially. So she's going to absolutely come for me. And my mum always says something to me, like when I go to America or when Brazilians come and fight me, she goes, don't think that she's coming here just for a fight. She's coming here to take everything from you. Take all your hype, take all the fans, take fucking everything. And that has to sit with me and resonate with me every day. And I'm not sure if you've seen, fucking hear Paddy there, white socks and slides. Get out. He's going fucking mad. My mantra, I'm the best in the world. I just repeat, rinse, and you'll have trolls, you go, oh, fuck off, Molly, you're not. But if I don't try and be and I don't think that I can be, why the fuck am I doing it? What other people say doesn't really matter to me. But for me to have that clear conviction and belief in myself, I have to reaffirm. Thanks, coach, see you later. And I'll be the best I can be, and if that's the case, I'll be the best in the world one day.
Weird it, lads.
So, and now you've been given a new one.
I know, because I'm a barstool athlete, I bought one without the fucking steak.com on it. But
I didn't even know you could do that.
Ah, Frank Lampard. I'm literally there. I'm right in there.
It's a shame we can't go to the ground.
Hello?
I bet you get VIP access around there, right?
No, that's I drinking the same food here with everyone.
Yeah, but do they not look after you?
No. Your legs are starting to look strong. Off me fucking bike. My mate Mo, who works for Everton, just messaged me saying he sent the new kit. But before the last UFC London, Everton was just having a mare. So I tweeted saying, can I come? And then they all made that. But he just said, I sent you a new case. I've already bought it. So much I love the club, I've already bought it. And I was listening to that on my way. I can't play it now because Paddy will lose the plot.
Yes, Paddy.
Good, good. I can't play this now. It's like you listen to your
network
alone.
Oh, yeah. we don't do that to each other.
Fair play to you.
I mean, he fucking every day, Everton shite, but.
I do hear that, to be fair. You do get the worst of it.
I do.
You say there's more just basically saying, like,
get
another
UFC card tonight.
Just
say the first one, I'll say the longer one. Yeah.
Okay,
got another. Me and the Meatball are finally for you.
We've got another UFC fight card tonight, fame.
Me and the Meatball have a parley for you. And if you bet with Barstool Sportsbook, you can take our picture.
What's
it called?
It's not
so good.
UFC
fight night.
Fight night.
You can just say there's another UFC
fight. Oh no, I want to see the card.
I know, I don't know who else is on.
What's happening, Stu?
Sorry.
Fucking hell, lads. Wait, let me read it one more time.
These are going to be
I am
filming.
The worst at this. You've got another UFC fight card. Wait, tell me when to go, son. What's happening, the Stoolies? We've got another UFC fight card tonight.
And me and the Meatball have a parlay for yous, don't we? Bet on Barstool Sportsbook, and yous will have boosted odds on our parlay.
I'm going to go with Courtney Casey to beat Antonina Shevchenko, because I fucking love her. I don't know if I'm allowed to swear, but I did. Big up Casey, Courtney, and I reckon it's going to go to a decision.
I'm going with the old veteran, Dos Anjos. He's fought a who's who of lightweight and welterweight in the UFC, and I think he's going to grind Fiziev out for the decision also.
I thought you said Fiziev. He's got
This camp has gone fantastic. I know I don't want to tempt fate by, you know, saying it's gone perfect, nothing's gone wrong or anything like that, but she is looking like the best version of herself that we've ever put out there, like, so very happy with her performances. So I feel like when I've watched Hannah, like, her strength really lies in the grappling. She's got to get hold of Molly to initiate that. She's got to deal with Molly's footwork first, and then the punches second, range third. So, like, I just feel like she's not going to get anywhere near Molly. Be prepared for the wall work that we think she's going to use. Be prepared for the bottom game, for Molly on the bottom of her. So, like, we're good to go. Like, Molly could fight her tomorrow, no problem.
My shoulders are ready to knock. Shoulders are ready to knock fuck out of this girl. I think you practice at being an analyst, like, first, don't you? And then you can be able to. It makes the show flow.
Dominic Cruz, for example, like, is a really good analyst. Not one that was a presenter, because he's got no personality. You've got personality, so that shines when you're a presenter.
Yeah.
But sometimes as an analyst, it doesn't work that way around. Like, if you think, like, the guys that do a lot of the play-by-play stuff, they're not very, like, good presenters.
What's the skinhead with the glasses who lost to John Jones once?
Anthony Smith.
Yeah. Unreal analyst. But if he has to present, he just switch off.
So that's why I think Bispin's like best of both, because Bispin has personality. He can do the in-cage interviews and have a laugh with you. He doesn't really present as much as he analyses, but I think his analysis is really good.
He can take control of the commentary in fight, can't he? Like, say if John Anakin did, and it was just him and Paul Felder, he can just...
He can take either role, can't he? Do you know what I mean? And his podcasts are funny, and, like, you know, the stuff he does, I think it's very good. Like,
I think...
You'll be able to become a hybrid, I think, by that point as well.
Yeah, 100%, because I'll be polished and not... I can put a different hat on for a different audience that I need. Like, say when I have to speak to, like, charities or fucking go into universities, I can change my vocabulary and speak different. When I don't swear live on air, I won't. Like, Me and Paddy's on that Gary Neville overlock the other day, and you want to see the comments. People just didn't expect me and him. They like, wow, after fights they're mental, but really on a what, like on the level they're just different. But
was that surreal for you?
Like, yeah, lads, I met Paddy, yeah. I just turned around and Gary Neville was there, and I was like, lads, it was me and Fran, because everyone was on holiday. So when me and Paddy took this fight, the deal was, because it's in July, every coach would have had a week off because it's the kids' holidays, and that would have been the summer holidays, so it was like sand. But it turned out there was like a 3-day layover where there was no coaches in. So I had little Francis Breen and just taking me on pads, and then so I threw this back and looked, and Gary was there, and I was like, but great.
How are you handling the fame after each fight? Because each time it's going up now, and I think it's fair to say you're somewhat of a people's champion now, right?
I think you can say that. I think it gets said quite a lot. I don't run around saying that myself, but that is the ultimate ethos and mentality I like to bring. I'm from fucking Council Estate. Chance the Rapper said a famous lyric, and he said, "The people's champ must be everything that the people can't be." So in them moments of adversity, and in them moments of like it's tough and it's rough and you just don't want to be there, I think about the people who look up to me, and then I think, right, well, I've got to do more. Like, I walk through this town and this city, and even places like Belfast and Dublin, and you just see how much you can give to the people who just love the sport, and you've just got to give more. Do you know, like, you've got that many people backing you. It's like, it's disrespectful to them if you fucking don't keep going. And when we're talking terms of fame, I don't like to say that so much. I like to just call it notoriety and reframe that word, because that's where you can get lost within yourself. And I think after the first 50 grand bonus, that fight last September, life completely changed on its head. And then it was just like partying and going to gigs and festivals and sporting events and just reaping the rewards of a lifetime's work. And then the last one, I got to go straight to America. I spent a month out there training, media, UFC fight shows, going to watch a hero in Rose Namajunas sit next to Misha Tate, fucking just chilling with the best of the best, and just them wanting to meet me. It fucking blew my mind. Like, and then I just, like, people proper get on your back, like, oh, them two, they're annoying and that, but we're just fans and can't believe it's happening to us. So we're like, oh my God, Dana. It's like, it's fucking mental. But I danced with the devil. I've had that moment where, like, you get found out and you have to reassess who's there, who's not there, who's there for the right reasons. What am I doing? Is this real life? Is it reality? No, it's not. So there's a lot of growth, and there's a lot of, like, there's so much on a plate being offered to you, and you have to just distinguish which is real and which is not. So this fight camp for me was more about going back to being on my own, just on my own, not going seeing my mates, not doing none of this, like being out of my comfort zone, and just why am I doing it? And like our conversation states before, like, my evolution of martial arts is plain to see for everyone. And going off the back of the last elbow, people will want me to be hyped, want me to be like, I'm going to beat that, I'm going to do that. No, I'm going to fucking go in there and show you someone totally different you've never seen before, and just show yet again another layer. No two fights of mine have been the same. The pace may have been the same, but shot selection and style may be press, but patterns, movement, flow, shot selection, trajectory of a backhand might have to be different for each opponent and the pattern that they walk in. And people would never think that's something I do. They probably just think, oh, she's angry, just gets in there and punches another bird's head. But there's so much more to it. When I run, I envisage a spinning elbow again. And I envisage, might not finish it, but it'll fucking do it in, and I'll save it. I don't need. I think the last time in the build up to the fight, I just said, like, I will put on a performance and the finish will come. And I hunted that finish. I fucking stalked it. I went after it with every beat in my heart, with every breath in my chest. But this time, I get to stay in the centre, stalk, and it'll come. It'll come. And I will get the finish again.